Good morning. Today I'm making some creamy and smooth eggless vanilla fruit custard. You can make this with or without custard powder. Using the same basic recipe, you can try different flavor variations such as kesar, coconut, caramel, chocolate, strawberry, mango, etc. You could also serve this as a sauce with your cakes, desserts and brownies. This is Suma Rauji and you're watching Cakes and More, your channel for beginners in baking. If you like this video, please do share and subscribe to my channel. Do not forget to tap the bell for email notifications. I have this very old recipe for vanilla pudding on my blog, and using this recipe as the base, I have tried different variations, but there'll be slight modifications, so please do check the recipes. I have given the links in the description box below the video. This recipe is just an idea, so please do try and make changes as you want it and try different variations. But for now, it's going to be some simple vanilla fruit custard. Please use standard measuring cups and spoons for measuring. We need some full fat milk. If you use low fat or skimmed milk, you'll not get the same results. It should never be warm or hot, or the cornflour will become lumpy. If you want to make kesar or rasmalai custard, take 2 teaspoons milk, heat and add the saffron. Let it sit for some time, then add it to the cold milk and continue with the recipe. If using saffron powder, you can add it directly. In the same way, you can also add instant coffee to a teaspoon of hot milk to make the coffee custard. We need some cream to make the custard thick and rich. If you do not use cream, you will need to use more cornflour, and I don't like that texture. I am using Amul fresh cream. I do not like to use malai from milk, it will not give the same thickness. Cornflour, this is very commonly available. I am using slightly less cornflour. You can use a little more if you prefer thicker custard. If you want, you can use custard powder instead of cornflour, but I prefer cornflour. Sugar to taste. Good vanilla extract. This is very important as it's the only flavor in the fruit custard. If you would be using vanilla essence, please start with just 2 to 3 drops because it is very strong. Add more if necessary after tasting. Unsalted butter. This is optional. I don't always use it. We'll take a small quantity of the cold milk, add the cornflour and whisk it. We need to make sure there are no lumps here. A small whisk works best for this. If there are lumps, the custard will not be thick and smooth. No lumps here. If you want to make coconut custard, you can add some coconut milk powder along with the custard powder. Take the cold milk in a heavy saucepan, this is important, or the custard will stick to the bottom. Add the custard mixture and whisk. A whisk is again the best tool to use. Helps mix really well. To make caramel flavored custard, you can stir in some caramel condensed milk into the milk mixture at this point. Now put this on low heat and keep whisking continuously. If you don't whisk constantly, there'll be lumps. After 4 to 5 minutes, the custard will turn thick, it will boil. Take it off the heat. If you want to add butter, you can add it at this point. If you want to make chocolate custard, you need to add chopped chocolate to the hot custard and mix. Now we'll strain this just in case there are any lumps. Stir in the vanilla. We need to cover this with plastic wrap so a skin doesn't form on top. The plastic wrap has to touch the surface of the custard. Let it cool completely. If you want to add strawberry puree or mango puree, you must mix it only after the custard cools completely. Otherwise, the custard may split. Strain again if needed. Wrap with cling film and chill for at least 3 to 4 hours. The custard will thicken further in the fridge. So this is the custard after chilling. If you want to use this as a sauce with dessert, use slightly less cornflour. I like to add the fruit just before serving. Sometimes some fruits may leave out water and that might dilute the custard. So this was one recipe with so many variations. I hope you'll try this and leave your comments for me. I'll be back soon with more tips and recipes. Please subscribe and stay tuned.